that, Norman. Can you tell us a bit about the background of the International Sheepdog Society?
Well, the society has a long history. 1906 it was formed, but I wasn't there personally. I don't remember anything of it. But no, joking apart, the society has been established, obviously, between the wars and right up to modern time. It's always been interested in developing the border collie, and it's been based around the shepherd, the working man and woman, the farmer, and how to make that dog stronger.
So how does the ISDS work now in the new millennium?
I think nowadays we've still got the same objective. It's to improve the shepherd's dog. And to improve that dog, we're interested in its strength, its ability through breeding. Certainly things like its health and eye testing and looking at hip dysplasia. And also about bringing on more interested folk. And it doesn't matter if they're hobbyists or youngsters or older people. We're bringing in training as well.
One of the questions that really seems to come up when we're talking about the ISDS is young handlers, new blood coming into the organisation.
Yes, you're quite right. We're paying attention to inviting youngsters in, quite a few young people's trials, certainly Northumberland, very good for bringing in youngsters. And I think you've seen at the trial here today, two young ladies, really good and quite wonderful. And in Ireland 2 weeks ago, we had three young men. In fact, the youngest, a 14-year-old, competing on the field, and you'd think that wouldn't be possible, but they do a really good job, and we're pleased to see them.
Yes, now you mentioned two young ladies. Shepherding's often been regarded as the last bastion of manfolk.
Ah.
How are the old school welcoming the young ladies into the old
school? Well, there are some lady shepherds, you know. Obviously, shepherding is a difficult craft to follow. It's part of the countryside, and therefore, there's not a lot of money in it. Folk are finding it a lifestyle choice, and where they're lucky and they can choose to do so, their whole life changes. And there are people interested in things other than money and fortune in the City of London, and I think that interest in looking after the countryside and being involved in the dogs will always be there for everybody, man and woman.
The main events of the ISDS, you run trials all over the country.
Well, yes. I mean, obviously, our sort of core job day to day is registering the Border Collie and looking after member interests. And then we get together in the summer to hold these four national trials, England, Ireland, Scotland, Wales. And then we're looking for the top 15 dogs from the four nations, and they go to the international trial, England, Ireland, Scotland, Wales, where we really sort out which dogs have got the skill, the eye, and the ability and the strength. And that's how the breed gets improved, by looking at dogs that still retain those strengths to do the job.
It is the International Sheepdog Society.
Well, yes. It's a British-Irish institution, and in fact, it's been lovely that Ireland is one country. Obviously, you can understand there are questions within Ireland on how they work, but it's one country, and the four nations have got the society. But I think we're more excited today by the fact that we've been joined by Germany, the Netherlands, Italy, Czechoslovakia, and even Brazil. So, in fact, the old International Society of Four Nations really is now becoming a world society. And you've probably heard about the World Sheepdog Trials. And next year, 2008, we've a big event in South Wales, and there'll be thousands of people coming from America, even some from New Zealand, for a world event. And we're thrilled about that.
Well, I hope we'll be there as well. Thank you very much indeed.
Look forward to seeing you then.